How would you like to take a cruise from Morehead City, North Carolina, all the way out to Bermuda, and then after refueling, on to New York City? Some 1,500 miles of open ocean. High adventure? Oh, yeah. Especially since you'll be making the voyage in a flats boat.
This flats boat, an open boat only 21 feet long. Flats boats are designed for sheltered water, not the open ocean, which for designer and builder Ralph Brown wasn't good enough.
Basically spent two and a half years dreaming about a better way to make a boat. And my wife finally said to me, either do it or shut up. She thought I was going to shut up. Here we are 4.5 years later with a boat that can run in very shallow water, at the same time handle rough seas without feeling like that your life's in danger.
And that's what Ralph set out to prove, the seaworthiness of his design. A tunnel-hulled catamaran, it draws only a few inches of water. The hulls and gunwale are designed to cast waves and spray away from the boat, so it's remarkably dry. And the hulls are filled with closed-cell foam, so it's theoretically unsinkable and is self-bailing. So with hundreds of gallons of extra fuel tankage, emergency supplies, and satellite phone, Ralph and his brother set out on their unprecedented and risky odyssey. As anticipated, it wasn't smooth sailing. They encountered up to 8-foot seas on the voyage and weighted down with all that extra fuel and provisions. They didn't make the speed they had planned for, but they made it over 1,500 miles of open ocean.
Have you proven what you set out to do?
Absolutely.
How?
This boat, in my opinion, is the world's most seaworthy flats boat. I mean, it runs in 4 to 6 inches of water and easily handles, 8 footers.
Bob Height on the Nautical News Beat for News Channel 8.
Taking a small boat into a big body of water is probably not a good idea, but a Hudson man did just that and has a world record to prove it.
How safe would you feel on a 21-foot motorboat traveling from the coast of North Carolina to Bermuda, then on to New York? Pretty safe, probably, as long as Bill Murphy's not driving, right? Well, the Hudson man behind this 1,500-mile trip and behind the boat that made it says it really wasn't that big of a deal on the Intruder. And new owners of this same boat, well, they were already convinced they found a winner.
Some boats can handle a chop, and some boats can run skinny. Yet some boats can't do either. We like to think ours does both.
Welcome to the Senior Outdoorsman with national fishing champion John Fox. John and his co-host share a lifetime of outdoor adventures.
We can't do as seniors what we could do when we were younger.
But there are ways you can still enjoy fishing and hunting as a senior outdoorsman.
Well, our special guest today, I'm very proud to have him. His name is Pierce Bush of the famous Bush family. Granddaddy, ex-President Bush, and uncle, right?
Exactly.
Who is our past president.
Yeah, you know, the one thing that's really impressive about this boat, especially right now when you look down, is how shallow the water is, and it feels so stable.
Mm-hmm.
It's an amazing build of a boat, and it's got a pretty big, nice size engine on the back.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
How fast does it go?
Well, it'll run comfortably 60.
No way. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but what I do like about it is what you said. You know, we've been fishing in water like that and like that. And this boat will actually, I can crank this motor and run in 10 inches of water.
Wow.
10
That's
inches
amazing.
Of water.
And you wouldn't even be able to tell. I mean, it's so stable. We could all be on this side of the boat.
Oh, yeah.
It still feels like flat and leveled
Absolutely.
Out.
Absolutely.
It's
but
pretty
it's,
amazing.
No, it's a good boat. The man really knows what he's doing. He set a new world's record leaving from North Carolina going nonstop to Bermuda, now across the Atlantic Ocean.
Gosh.
And if that wasn't enough, he left there then and went nonstop back to New York, and Guinness has recognized it as a new world record.
That's amazing.
In a fishing boat, a 21-foot fishing boat.
In the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It is. It really is.
So you bring this on saltwater also then?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, fresh or salt, either one.
It's perfect.
Yeah. There's been lots of boats on the market, including Skeeter that I was with for over 25 years. But there's nothing ever been developed on the water that's more suitable for a fisherman than this boat. Safe, you can't turn it over. Number two, I've had as high as 3 and 4 people on the side of it. It won't even tip, it stays steady, okay? It's because of the hull design, which is exclusive on this boat. Take it from me, John Fox, the Intruder, it's a winner, and it will be, I promise you.